Insane. This movie was insane. Welcome to I Just React and Review. My name is Ashmita and I hope you all are doing well. And today I want to share my thoughts with you on this Assamese movie that I was recommended to watch. The movie is called Amis and oh my god, I was blown away by this film. So yes, without delaying this any further, let's get into the detailed analysis. Okay, first things first, this movie is not everyone's cup of tea. I think the only two responses that this movie can garner from the audience is that one, oh my god, wow, and the second, oh my god, no. The story is definitely not for the faint-hearted. On the surface, it is a love story that we witnessed blossom between two people, a young PhD student, Sumon, and a doctor, Nirmali, who is several years elder to him. They bond over their love for different types of meat and Sumon deeply falls in love with her. But he knows that he can't do anything about it because Nirmali is a married woman with her own family. Nirmali also clearly develops feeling for him, but of course she restricts herself to express those emotions. But on a deeper context, this movie takes the idea of lust and forbidden love to another unbelievably crazy level. It explores the idea that forbidden fruit is very, very tempting and how far a person can go to acquire the taste of that fruit. Initially, while watching the film, I was like, okay, this is basically like a love story between two people who have a significant age difference. I see where this is going. I was so wrong. The twist in the storyline is something that I probably never ever imagined at all. Me being a non-vegetarian, the storyline completely creeped me out. But I was also awestruck that, oh my goodness, somebody actually thought of this kind of a plot and dared to explore it. So yes, for people who haven't watched this film yet, you have to go in with a completely blank mind, and that is why I'm not giving out anything about the storyline. The editing of this film is done by Shweta Rai, and I absolutely do not have any complaints regarding the edit of the film. The movie is slow paced, as it should be, because the makers want you to feel that slow burn. Even with that kind of pacing of the film, I did not find any dull moment. The scenes are quite engaging and the edit makes the arrival of the twist and the climax worthwhile. Riju Das is the cinematographer of the film. You will know while watching the film that this is not a very high budget movie, but with whatever budget the technical departments were provided, I think they have outdone themselves. The cinematography was quite good, and for me, the shots where the food was getting prepared, those close-up scenes, they were really aesthetically done. I particularly became a fan of all the close-up shots of the two principal characters. The camera spends a lot of time capturing their face, and it stays there for quite some time so that, you know, all the emotions of that person are getting registered in the audience's mind. For me, the score was a complete standout. As I mentioned before, how beautifully all the meal preparation scenes were getting captured, it has been backed by amazing sound design. The background score used for the romantic moments where these two principal characters are bonding over their love for meat is so beautiful. It's amazing. And the score used when that twist happens, it's so trance-like. It is going to play with your brain. The score where Nirmali, when having the meat, is feeling that nirvana sort of feeling, it's just unbelievably haunting and beautiful. I really want to applaud not just the person who has given the background score, but all the people in the sound department who would have done the mixing and everything. All of them need a round of applause for this. Bhaskar Hazarika is the director as well as the screenplay writer of this movie. It is his brainchild. This entire story is his brainchild. Firstly, when it comes to the writing and the story and the inception of this whole thought, I just want to applaud Bhaskar Hazarika for even thinking of such a storyline, because I feel when he would have pitched this idea to the producers, they would have thought that he was crazy. Not many makers would dare to explore such kind of a topic, because A, you do not know what kind of emotion it is going to invoke in the audience's mind, because the topic itself is so controversial. And B, to present such a topic molded into a love story, it's quite creative. Not everybody has such creativity. There are so many layers to the writing. If you go beyond the storyline, it will force you to think about certain aspects of life. His direction was fabulous. It was fabulous. You know, he sort of gave the clue about the gist of the film in the beginning of the movie itself, but he kept it so subtle that when that twist and that climax happens, the audience is going to get shocked. There are supporting cast in the film, but he never ever took the focus away from these two principal characters. It was only and only these two that the audience was made to concentrate on. The way he has brought out the acting talents of these two people, because I found out that it was their debut film, you know, Bhaskar Hazarika, just take a bow. Okay, let's talk about the two amazing performers of the film. Orgudeep Barua, who plays the character of Sumon, the PhD student, is so restrained and controlled in his acting. His entire demeanor is so calm and knowledgeable. He gives off that PhD student vibe. The way he delivered his dialogue, the way he expressed his love, the way he was longingly looking at the women whom he can't have, he was brilliant. But the show stealer of this movie is Leema Das. She was exceptional. She was beyond exceptional. I couldn't believe it was her first film, because she's such a natural. She has not missed any acting beat by even a nanosecond. Everything from her body language to her expressions to her dialogue delivery, her range of emotion was so perfectly delivered by her. And let me tell you, those eyes and that beautiful smile is so mesmerizing and captivating. You are gonna get sucked into it. And because both of them delivered such great performances, I loved the overall chemistry that these two had. It felt real, it felt authentic. I'm going to repeat what I said at the beginning of this video, is that this movie is not everybody's cup of tea. It is not for the faint-hearted. But the story just opens up so many topics of discussion. Number one, what is normal? Something which is normal for you might not be normal for me, or something which I consider as normal might be a little off-putting for others. Second, the preconceived notions and the judgments that we have in our mind about certain things. It's just going to make you realize one thing, is that all of us are judgmental. All of us, no matter what, we are judgmental people. If it is a good thing or a bad thing, that's up for debate. But we as human beings cannot sit on a high throne and say that, oh, you know what? People are judgmental, but I don't judge. We all judge others, period. Third, how far is too far when it comes to love? How far are you going to go? What is that line? What is that line that you draw that, okay, beyond this, I am not going to pursue my love interest and I'm just going to let it go. Overall, this movie is going to play with your brain. It didn't leave my mind for quite some time after I finished watching it. And like I said, it's going to invoke only two responses. Either it's going to be, oh my goodness, wow, or it's going to be, no way, no, what the F. You can catch this film at moviesaints.com. You have to pay a certain fee, of course, to watch it. My personal recommendation would be that if you do not like non-veg, don't watch it. But if you like unique and creative storylines, this is a movie that needs to be watched and cannot be missed. And thank you so much to this viewer who actually recommended this movie to me. I cannot thank you enough. This was a different kind of experience for me. So yes, that was me sharing my thoughts and my analysis on the Asmus film Amis. I hope you have come till the end of the video. If you have, thank you so much for watching. I'll see you on my next video. Bye bye.